Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Harry Adams, the Executive Chairman of KEFI Gold and Copper. Harry, good to see you this morning.
Good to be here, thank you.
You're welcome. KEFI recently put out its fourth quarter update. How did the company's performance align with its long-term strategic goals? And are there any shifts of strategy expected based on that update?
Well, the company was formed about 15 years ago, and right from the outset, we said we'd focus on frontier markets, but we've certainly done that. And we said we'd focus on making low-cost discoveries of what we considered low-hanging fruit, and we've done that. We've discovered some 5 million ounces, 2 million ounces to our account, and it's cost us $32 per ounce all up, considering all the money that's been spent in Ethiopia and Saudi Arabia. So that's very cost effective. The average, if you like, industry valuation benchmark for such ounces in development assets is about 10 times that number. So yeah, that's exactly what we said we'd do. And we've formed very strong local alliances to help us achieve that and for social licensing, and we've done that. So I think we're right on what we said, yeah.
You mentioned you operate in Ethiopia and Saudi Arabia. Could you provide updates on those mining jurisdictions?
Well, they were very hard going until the last 2 years, both of them, really, for different reasons. Security issues in both of different types, the protection of our property rights, regulatory hurdles. We could write a book about all of that. But the bottom line is that in the last 2 years, I think quite coincidentally, they've both turned, you know, right onto the front foot and are very, very keen to develop their mining sectors. It's being demonstrated by their actions now. And we're quite at the forefront of the sector. The rest of the industries are arriving by the plane load now because it's also positive.
And the significance of the discovery announced today in Saudi Arabia?
Well, it's a particularly gratifying discovery, you know, for us, because it was our first discovery at Jibal Qutman Gold in Saudi Arabia. In the first few years, we were in the country, and then no sooner had we discovered it that we were evicted from the site over administrative regulatory issues, which took 8 years, believe it or not, to resolve. And then we got back onto the ground only a year ago, and now we've made another discovery. So it's been a belated reward for resilience or persistence, and it's particularly gratifying. Also, intellectually, from an exploration point of view, it reflects the fact that we've got some insights now, and we've worked it out in a way which is extremely encouraging for the rest of the property, and we haven't explored most of it yet, so it's extremely encouraging and rewarding, to be honest.
You report that KEFI is being funded by a joint venture partner. How does that work?
Well, it sounds unusual, I think, in the corporate world, but I think just think of it in simple terms. We've got a 15-year-old partnership. It's a strong relationship. There's deep trust, deep interdependence, and we're run off our feet and stretched really financially as a company because we're doing so much right now, and we're looking to trigger the development in Ethiopia, and then we're looking to trigger the development in Saudi Arabia, Jibal Qutman, not long thereafter this year. So we're flat out, and our partners said, well, cut us a bit of slack, really, said, I'll carry you and you catch up later and let's keep both of them rolling. So it's not complex to understand. It's just, I suppose, a bit unusual in the corporate world to see two partners working so collaboratively, perhaps.
I mean, you also recently announced the lead bank final approval of the financing package of $320 million for the Tulu Kapi gold project. Can you give us the details of the financing and who's putting up the money?
The lead bank is Eastern and Southern African Trade and Development Bank, or TDB, and the co-bank is AFC, Australian African Finance Corporation, sorry. And between them, they're putting up about 70% of the money. About 10% of the money is from our partner, which in Ethiopia is the government. So that's up to 80%. About 10% or a bit more is coming in the form of equity-style capital from subsidiaries of major multinational corporations who've got retained earnings trapped in the country in Ethiopia, and they're being given special permission by government to invest into our group to deploy their capital into a hard currency asset. That leaves a bit under 10% of the project, which on paper we've covered, but we need to finesse it at the last minute, to be honest, when all the people have gone firm. We just need to finesse the last 10% as to exactly who covers it in which way. But yeah, it's essentially all done at the subsidiary level.
Harry, what's the next steps for KEFI Gold? Are there any specific developments investors should keep an eye out in the coming months?
Yes. The fact that Tula Kapi is in its finance closing process now, which takes a few months, is community preparation, which takes 3 months, which has started. A legal docs, which will be within that period. And satisfaction of residual conditions precedent, which will be within that period. So that process will yield some steps along the way that we'll report, obviously. Later in the year, there'll be the analogous process for Jibal Qutman in Saudi. So next to the financing of those two projects will be project definition work in Saudi, deciding which of the scenarios it will press the trigger on for Jibal Qutman development. And thirdly, exploration is being revved up outside our development assets. We have three development assets, Tula Kapi, Jibal Qutman, one in Ethiopia, one in Saudi. And we have a much bigger one coming along behind to be developed after the first two up and running, Hawiya in Saudi Arabia. So we have a pipeline of three advanced projects, but we are at the same time revving up regional exploration to maintain that pipeline for the long term so that there's another major development coming along for down the track. And we're looking for things bigger again. No, he's looking for things smaller than what we already have. So, the fact that the two countries turned positive over the last 2 years means that we're picking up the pace, if you like, on these projects, and therefore the news flow should just reflect that as we move forward.
Well, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress, Harry. Thank you very much for the update today.
It's my pleasure. Thank you very much.
Harry Adams, Executive Chairman of KEFI Gold and Copper.